Good morning, student. Today we will continue our chapter 11, Understanding Elementary Shape. And today we will discuss the classification of triangle. We will discuss classification of triangles. According to sides, according to angles. Firstly, we will discuss according to side. In a triangle, we know that we have three sides and three angles. Three sides, then see, according to sides, we have three types of triangle. One is scalene triangle, isosceles, equilateral. In the scalene triangle, what is the meaning of scalene triangle? That in a triangle, if all the sides are different, agar tino sides kisi triangle ki different hai, then we can say that it is a scalene triangle. Isosceles triangle, if in a triangle any two sides are equal, any two sides of a triangle are equal, then it is called isosceles triangle. Equilateral triangle, in this triangle all the three sides are equal, then it is called an equilateral triangle. Scalene triangle, all sides are different. Isosceles triangle, any two sides are equal. An equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. So according to side, we have three types of triangle, that is a scalene, isosceles and equilateral. Now see, according to angle, we have acute angle triangle. What is the meaning of acute? Acute angle kya hota hai? An angle lies between 0 degree to 90 degree, then it is called an acute angle. So what is the meaning of acute angle triangle? So in a given triangle, if all the angles are less than 90 degree, if all the angles are less than 90 degree, then it is called acute angle triangle. Next is obtuse angle. Can we say that in this triangle all the angles are greater than 90 degree? If all the angles are greater than 90 degree, then sum of all the angles become greater than 180 degree. Then it is not a triangle. It means an obtuse angle triangle. What is the meaning of this? Any one of the angle greater than 90 degree, then it is called obtuse angle triangle. Any one of the angle greater than 90 degree, then it is called obtuse angle triangle. Right angle triangle. In right angle triangle, any one of the angle is equal to 90 degree. In a triangle, any one of the angle is equal to 90 degree, then it is called right angle triangle. In the right angle triangle and obtuse angle triangle, only one of the angles should be obtuse or equal to 90 degree. Other two angle always will be acute angle. Other two angles always will be acute angle. But it doesn't mean that it is an acute angle triangle. Because what is the definition of acute angle triangle? ऑल द एंगल्स शुड बी एक्यूट एंगल. एक भी एंगल अगर ऑब्ट्यूज हुआ, मीन्स ग्रेटर देन 90 डिग्री हुआ, देन इट बिकम्स ऑब्ट्यूज एंगल ट्राइंगल. इफ वन ऑफ द एंगल इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री, देन इट बिकम्स राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. बिकॉज बट मोर देन वन एंगल इज नॉट पॉसिबल हेयर दैट इज इक्वल टू दैट इज ऑब्ट्यूज और राइट एंगल. So there should be only any one of the angle. These are the definition of triangles according to sides and angles. Now see, questions we will discuss. Okay, in a right angle triangle, one important term we have, that the side opposite to right angle, this one opposite angle, this one right angle, side opposite to right angle is called hypotenuse. Side opposite to right angle is called hypotenuse. Now see, let's discuss one question. It is given to you, classify the triangles the measure of whose sides are given below as scale and isosceles or equilateral. If it is given like this, 6 cm, 8 cm, 10 cm, all the sides are different, it means it is a scale and triangle. That's this type you can identify according to the side, scale and isosceles or equilateral. Similarly, one angles are given to you, 58 degree, 83 degree, 39 degree. Which type of triangle it is? Firstly, see this is a triangle or not. Means these three angles are forming a triangle or not. How can we check? What we will do? We will do add all the angle. Eight or nine, 17 or 320. 8, 3, 11, 5, 6 or 2, 18, 16 or 2, 18. It means these three angles are forming a triangle, it is correct. But now which type of triangle it is? Acute, obtuse or right angle? Right angle, no one angle is 90 degree. So it is not right angle. And greater than 90 degree also not here. So it is not obtuse angle. All the angles are less than 90 degree. It means they will form acute angle triangle. Okay, now see the next. One question is given to you that all equilateral triangle are isosceles but all isosceles triangles are not equilateral. Why? Very easy question. All equilateral triangles are isosceles because all equilateral means all the sides are equal. All the sides are equal. It means we can take any two sides are also equal. That we can write down in this triangle that AB is equal to BC, BC is equal to CA, AB is equal to CA, like this also. It means any two sides are also equal. So we can say all equilateral triangles are isosceles triangle. But if to any isosceles triangle it is given to you AB is equal to BC, then AB does not equals to CA and BC also not equals to CA. It means all the sides are not equal. That means it is not an equilateral triangle. So we can say all equilateral triangle are isosceles triangle, but all isosceles triangle are not equilateral triangle. Now see the classification of quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is what? A closed figure which has four sides. कोई भी क्लोज फिगर इफ क्लोज प्लेन फिगर इफ इट हैज फोर साइड्स देन इट इज कॉल्ड अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल. इन दिस फिगर वी कैन से वन साइड ए बी बी सी सी डी डी ए एंड इट इज अ क्लोज फिगर ऑल्सो ए बी बी सी सी डी देन अगेन डी. सो एनी क्लोज फिगर विच हैज फोर साइड्स are quadrilateral. In this quadrilateral we can say we have four vertices also, four sides, four vertices and four angles. Basically it is a quadrilateral. Now in the classification of quadrilateral we have different types of quadrilateral. In this we will be familiar with all the name. That first if I discuss about the trapezium, I am taking the shape of all type of quadrilateral. Trapezium is something like this. Second, if we are taking, that is a rectangle. Third, I am taking square. Trapezium, rectangle. Parallelogram. Rhombus. These type of quadrilateral we will discuss: trapezium, rectangle, square, parallelogram, rhombus, like this. Now in this C, firstly we will discuss about the trapezium. These are the family of quadrilateral we can say. The first figure of quadrilateral we will discuss about the trapezium. Trapezium is what? In a trapezium, one of the pair of sides in a quadrilateral is parallel. किसी भी क्वाड्रिलेटरल में कोई भी पेयर, वन ऑफ द पेयर ऑफ द साइड, साइड्स का कोई भी पेयर, अपोजिट पेयर वी कैन से, इफ पैरेलल देन वी कैन से इट इज अ ट्रैपेजियम. Then see, I can make like this also. Then also this is a trapezium. Any one of the side, maybe this one AB parallel to DC or maybe AD parallel to BC. Any one of the pair of opposite sides are parallel, opposite sides is parallel, then it we can say it is a trapezium. In a trapezium, one more thing, if these are called the parallel sides, then remaining two called non-parallel side. And if non-parallel sides are equal, in a trapezium, if non-parallel sides are equal, then it is called a isosceles trapezium. Isosceles word come with the two sides equal. So in a trapezium, if non-parallel sides are equal, then it is called a isosceles trapezium. So this is about the trapezium. Now the next, parallelogram, second quadrilateral, parallelogram. Parallel, it means we are something related to parallel lines. In a quadrilateral, if both pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other, both pair of opposite side, here pair of opposite side AB and DC, here AD and BC, both pair of opposite sides are parallel, it means AB parallel to DC, AD parallel to BC, then we can say this given quadrilateral is a parallelogram. And one more property of this parallelogram, then opposite sides are parallel and equal also. In a parallelogram, we know that opposite sides are parallel and equal also. So it is called a parallelogram. Now we can say one of the thing that these are the types of parallelogram. Rectangle. In a rectangle, also it is a type of parallelogram. So, opposite pair of sides are parallel, but they are forming each angle is equal to 90 degree also. It has the property of parallelogram plus one more property that each angle is equal to 90 degree. That's why it is called a rectangle. It means parallelogram plus one property that each angle is equal to 90 degree, then it is a rectangle. Next, square. Square is also a type of parallelogram, or you can say rectangle also, but one more property we will add in it, that all the sides are equal, opposite sides are parallel, but and each angle is equal to 90 degree. It means it has the property of rectangle plus one more property, that is all the sides are equal also. Then it is called a square. Next, rectangle, square, rhombus. It is not a type of parallelogram. In a rhombus, it is a type of parallelogram in which all the sides are equal. These lines are parallel plus all the sides are equal. We can't say about the angles. So, this is called a rhombus. Sixth one, kite. In a kite, adjacent sides are equal. In a kite, adjacent sides are equal. It is a type of quadrilateral in which adjacent sides are equal. So this complete is the classification of quadrilateral. We will discuss questions related to this classification in our next lecture. So you will try your exercise 11th D and 11th E. Okay, student, thank you. Have a nice day.